Sean Baker.
Welcome to 64, the worst show ever.
We're back, ladies and gentlemen, and it's worse than ever, and, you know.
Words right out of my mouth.
Who knows what the fuck's going on with the world, but we are going to do, just for safety precautions, the entire episode with our masks on. So, Sean, if you would grab yours.
Shit.
You got to do me. I know, but I don't feel safe talking to you unless you're wearing it.
Yeah, all right. Let me grab it. I'll be right back.
All right. All right, thank you. So, guys, what's going on in the world? Well, for one thing, we're being safe.
You know, these are really fogging up my glasses, dude. I don't know about this.
All right. Anyways, guys, we have some very exciting news. What's our exciting news?
Hold on a second. Let me take my fucking mask off. Great idea, by the way, there, Harpy. Oh, man.
Sketched Actually, out. You know what? Oh, I was going to say we should just show the video.
You know what? Show the video.
Okay.
That's good. It's a good idea.
All right. So,
which video, though?
Some exciting news, the first one, right?
Okay.
So we saw some exciting news, and check this out. Ladies and gentlemen, is the exciting news. We are.
We're back, baby.
We're doing Sketched Out, baby.
Sketched Out is back. Yeah, we are so excited to announce it. Oh, man. I mean, if anybody was there for the first Sketched Out, thank you for coming. It was a great night. Everybody had a good time. We had Joe Grillo, Stephen Gaines, one fucking hilarious sketch.
Yep.
Comedy Store La Jolla featured it on the webpage. It was a great night. Super fun. Now, look, we're all stuck in this pandemic. I know a lot of people making sketches. The submissions that have been coming in are insane. I mean, it's ridiculous how my phone is just going off constantly. Submission.
Even the great, should we say, from Kill County, the great Michael Lair is submitting his sketch.
They're hilarious.
Yep.
Very funny. Hey, get them in. Submit. Start submitting your sketches. Anybody, anywhere. December 3rd is the deadline. That's when we're going to stop accepting the submissions. We have a ton to look through. So we've already started sorting out. Some people just don't follow the directions. They think like a 15-minute sketch of their own is something that's going to happen in an hour and 30 minutes, you know? 3 yeah. to 5 minutes, guys. Keep the sketches 3 to 5 minutes.
And guys, listen, you know, we're all about answering questions, but it's very easy to submit, okay? All you have to do is go to jpdentertainment.com, you click on the sketched out tab, and you load right here.
There you go.
Fill out your team name, Jobby's Peeps, and that's pretty much how you do it. Or if you don't even feel like doing that, look, it's right here on the site. It says, click here to submit for sketched out. You click that and it takes you right to the same thing. So very simple. If you can't follow that, you probably just shouldn't even submit your video. Okay. So,
yeah. So, you know, we were going to be, streaming this live on Twitch at the Comedy Store in Hollywood.
Yep.
And, listen, COVID regulations are changing.
At Comedy Store, guys. So you go to Twitch, you download the app for Twitch, or you go to twitch.tv, and it's literally right there. It says on a search bar.
Check it out. You'll be able to watch the show. It's going to be a great time. Look, COVID restrictions are kind of happening. Curfews are being put in place. Certain things are getting shut down. So we're going to adapt no matter what. That's what the video is all about. So no matter what the show is going down, it's going to be on Twitch, streaming live from the Comedy Store. If we can get people out on the patio legally at that point, it'll be packed. So we're super excited.
And it might change. Who knows? They said 3 weeks. So by December 10th, it might change. But right now, it shit's all fucked up. So either way, we're streaming it live on Twitch. You know, and you know,
submit, you know, if you don't know, now you know, start submitting. Anybody, look, this is your chance. This is your chance to get your submissions in, get your video seen.
This is
so
many
stuff. There's so many talented people out there. I'm one of those guys that, man, I grew up at a different time where if you were a great singer and you just didn't have the means, you're never gonna make it. You know, you were never going to really be what maybe you could have been. Yep. But there's so many people who know people and then just like end up on American Idol and they get pushed through, they win, and then hey. But there's a show like American Idol was when it first started, was such a good show because it kind of gave people the opportunity something. Oh. I gotta take this call from my landlord real quick. Hold on a second.
Wait, hang on.
Show a video.
Earphones or...
Show a video.
Fuck. All right, boys and girls, I hope you can hear me. I didn't hear a word Sean said. I'm assuming he got a phone call. So pretty much, I'm going to take it from here. I got to be honest, I'm a little shy to be on camera by myself. But what Sean, I think, was going to say is this is a great opportunity for you guys to get the word out. Hey. Can you hear me? Hey.
Couldn't hear a word you were saying. Me? I don't know if you're even talking or not.
Can you not hear me now?
Colton, can you hear me?
You can't hear me?
Yeah, we heard everything. Listen, I'm back, so it doesn't matter. But this is the time. I don't know what you were saying because I wasn't listening. But my landlord called and he just got back and I feel he just had to.
Yeah, fuck him. No one gives a shit.
He's the best. But it's sketched out. Amazing. Go ahead. What were you saying?
I was saying that it's a great opportunity to get your shit out there. And I think what you were going to say before you rudely interrupted me was being from like a small town or something. I'm from Connecticut. I know Sean's from Schenectady, Kentucky.
Schenectady, Kentucky? What the fuck are those places?
What's that bullshit town you always say when you ask people if they're from New York?
I ask them if they're from Schenectady. It's a weird town. There's not a lot of people in there. I used to live with a kid who was from Schenectady, so I used to make fun. But it's funny because when I say it, everybody laughs like Schenectady. Like, especially if you're from New York, they're not. Anyway,
but what I was saying is, you know, I grew up in Newington, Connecticut. Okay, it's a small fucking town. In Connecticut, most people don't even think of Connecticut for anything really. So this is a great opportunity. We're accepting sketches, not only across the nation, but across the world. If they're not in English, we got a couple that aren't in English. They're in subtitles. So we've got
translators too.
Yeah.
People who are actually going to be there doing the signing and everything. Everything. Yep. I don't know how to do the signs, but they're going to do them so they understand. This is for everybody. Wait, do they sign?
I don't know what you're talking about, but I'm just going with it.
Hey. It's funny that you're trying to finish my idea that I rudely interrupted you back on when I had to take a phone call. So what I was saying before is, like, shows like American Idol are great because they were able to take small town people and get them out there, because these people are all over the world, super talented. People in Schenectady, people in Oklahoma and shit. People, you know, who this is the time to fucking get it out there. Let's see what you got. Bring out the Hollywood, you know, show your sketches.
The winner, we fly out here in 2024.
Yeah, in 2024, we'll bring you out here.
We should put that, dude. That's a good idea.
But remember that show? Did you ever see Nathan For You? Remember that episode where people got like free gas, but they had to do these whole things of stipulations? So they ended up having to hike this like mile mountain, and then by the time they got there, they had to like camp out overnight, and like if they didn't do that, they didn't get the free gas. Like
$40 worth of gas, right?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah,
and then pretty much everyone gave up except like there were like three or four people and him, he keeps telling the owner of the gas station, he's like, don't worry, they're gonna give up. I know they're gonna give up.
It was a promotion. He got these people to stay the night, and then like in the morning he's like, isn't the promotion guys there? Like, yeah, we didn't think so.
But they were cool with it. They're like, we just, you know, having fun.
They had a good time. You know, they just were like, they had nothing to do. Free-spirited people. There's special people out there, man.
That's one of my favorite shows. Or was, you know, also Eric Andre's show tonight. Last fucking two episodes of the season. It kind of sucks that he does two at a time, even though they're short. I know. Amazing. Those are literally my favorite type of shows. Eric Andre's show, Nathan For You, Tom Green's show, Ali G's show. Just those type of shows. I love those.
Dude, you know what I watched last night? That, I'm not gonna lie, man, I felt like a little bitch. I was like getting teary-eyed and emotional. That only happens when I'm high too. Like when I'm high, I can get a little emotional. Otherwise, I'm never really emotional. I don't give a shit. Fuck you. But when I'm high, like I kind of have feelings like that. You know, like feelings. And it's interesting because, bro, on HBO Max right now, they have the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air reunion, and it's
I saw that.
15 minutes. Did you watch the whole thing?
No, I think I don't want to say it wasn't my time, or I just never got into French Prince of Bel-Air, however the fuck you say it.
The French Prince? The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. No, I never got into it.
Oh, man.
I know. I probably should now that it's... Wait, so are they doing a comeback show or is it just a reunion?
Well, they are doing... So... There's a new show in the works. It's just called Bel Air, I think.
Like fucking Full House.
Save by the Bell is going to be streaming on Peacock starting on the 24th, I believe.
I don't think you can say that word on air.
Well, Peacock is a free streaming service by NBC, and it's streaming on a lot of shit, but not most shit.
They're taking the fucking Office come January. So if you guys haven't watched it, you better get your full. Binge on.
You gotta watch it until you're sick of it. You gotta watch it till you're like, ugh. And then maybe 6 months later, you'll be craving it again.
What, The Office?
Yeah.
Oh, dude, yeah. When me and Anita first met, and I say me and Anita because I don't like saying Anita and I, for those of you who are correcting my fucking English out there, we binge watched The Office. And it was like my sixth time probably watching it through. First two or three episodes, she's like, I don't like this show. I'm like, dude, you got to give it a fucking chance. And she loved it.
You know, The Fresh Prince was such an awesome show. I grew up with it, and I watched all of it. I mean, I couldn't wait for it to come on. I watched it when it aired.
Was it one of those shows that came on Friday nights? Like, it was like the Friday night?
No, it came on Monday night. It came on Monday night during Monday Night Football.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
That's ballsy.
It is. But it was like, it was cool. It was cool, like, going back and forth. And then sometimes you just forget that you were watching football because you're watching Fresh Prince. Dude, it was just such a, it was a great show. Because, like, back then, there was such an awesome formula for sitcoms. And watching this reunion was amazing because I loved the show. I've seen every episode multiple times. And seeing, like, and Aunt Viv, like, the mother of everybody except for, you know, it's Will's aunt. They ended up, some shit went down in real life. She got fired from the show. And here's a brand new Aunt Viv. So you're watching it the next season and you're like, who the fuck is this lady? You know what I mean?
That's like when they got rid of Charlie Sheen and they brought in Ashton Kutcher. And they're like, what?
Dude, I know.
Fucking stupid.
So dumb. But bro, that's exactly what it was like. I mean, that's happened. And that happened in Roseanne it was Darlene and her sister, the other girl, Becky. So yeah, all of a sudden one season comes up, like, what the fuck? And this girl's Becky. You're like,
dude, that's like in fucking Batman. They had who's the cute girl from Dawson's Creek?
Katie Holmes.
They had Katie Holmes, right? Then the first one, and then they just something happened, and then the second one, totally different actress.
Yeah, dude. I mean, that happens often.
What?
But it was weird because honestly, I loved the first Aunt Viv. She was the shit, man.
How many seasons was she on?
The show was on for six. She was on for three. So I think they pretty much
split. Yeah, you can't fucking do that.
And I always knew that it was like between her and Will, but I didn't know really the story behind it. And I'm definitely not going to ruin anything right now. You should go, and anybody who's watching this, go on HBO Max. And watch it and just get your free week or whatever the hell it is, and then watch that. There's a bunch of really great shit on HBO Max. Watch Curb Your Enthusiasm if you haven't watched that. The brand new season from this year is on there. Just there's a lot of great shit. We'll take advantage of that free week. We actually did, but we like it so much that we just decided to hold on to it for a little bit. But the
HBO Max.
Yeah. And the Fresh Prince reunion was amazing because they brought everybody together except Uncle Phil. He passed away a few years back, which is really sad. So his uncle on the show, the dad, he's not there. But the second Aunt Viv was there with Hillary and all the everybody except for the Uncle Phil. Even like Jeffrey the butler was there, and I mean, everybody, all the main characters in the show, it was awesome. And then, except for the first Aunt Viv. And then towards the very end of the show, he kind of was like, hey, you know, we can't do this special without mentioning fucking Aunt Viv. You know, she was the queen, she was this and that. And then he was like, I actually met her for lunch. And she spoke with Will Smith for the first time in 27 years, the day before they shot this. And they kind of just let each other know what was going on, and man, it was crazy. It was crazy to watch the shit. You know, this is a 29-year-old kid who has no fucking clue what it's like to be like an older woman who was pregnant at the time in her life.
Wait, Will was 29 at the time of the show?
He was saying he was so young. Everybody, people who were auditioning for this, he said he got the role like right away. Like they knew that they wanted him.
So was he famous before this show or no?
He was rapping. Yeah, he was DJ Jazzy Jeff and the Fresh Prince. I used to have his tapes when I was a fucking kid. Dude. You remember that song Summertime?
Yeah, no, I know that. But I thought that was because of the show.
No, that was before the show.
Oh shit!
Quincy Jones is like a big time.
That's
guy.
Rashida Jones's father.
He was like a big time music guy and television guy. He went.
He did stuff with Michael Jackson too, right?
Yeah, he did. He was a big time. He was big time. You could work with if you could work with him. Oh my god! But he wanted it. He wanted this for Will Smith. But it was just a great thing. Just watch the doc. Watch it. I mean, everybody should just go on HBO Max and watch the Fresh Prince of Bel-Air reunion. This has nothing to do with the remake. The remake is called Bel-Air. It's supposed to be more of like a drama series. It's not a comedy.
And is Will in the remake?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, so they just take some...
I think they're just doing it kind of like some sort of weird spinoff, but... dude, I mean, the episodes of The Fresh Prince, they're like, there's times where, like, the one with his dad, like, he never, like, his dad was, like, a truck driver, never really saw him, and then, like, comes into town and, like, he's promising Will all these things, and Will gets... it's just like, man, the end of that episode is unbelievable. And then listening to him tell that at the reunion, it was just like you just start to like tear up like a little bitch, like, oh my god, like it's just, you know, because he was saying what Uncle Phil meant to him, and with that scene right there, and like he kept telling him, no, you gotta fucking, you know, you gotta do it. And then Will started, he was talking about going to the scene, how he fumbled his lines, then he grabbed him and just kind of said something to him, and they said right back into the scene, and then Will was into the scene. It was a really emotional scene. Will started crying and then like broke down, and they hugged, and Will said, you know, when we were hugging, he was like, that's how you act. But Will's like all broken down and crying. It was an amazing scene. It's like, it was really something. Like, the shows,
yeah.
They had really good, strong, you know, points throughout that, the entire six seasons of that show. And it's a great show. And that the whole entire six seasons is also streaming on HBO Max. So if you've never seen it, you know, you can go catch up on those episodes. I know that the new shit is either going to be on HBO Max, which kind of would make sense for it right now, but Netflix is also trying to kind of put up a bid for it, so I guess it comes down to money, like most things, so we'll see.
And pussy.
Yep. Money and pussy.
Yeah, that's cool. I didn't know they were doing that. Well, actually, I saw on his Instagram. You know, it's funny, I bought a... Jesus, I hope there's not a severe lag on this stream. Oh, never mind. I was like looking at it on Facebook and we're just clapping. I'm like, oh,
yeah. Yeah, my microphone was all fucked up. It turned off and then I had to turn it back on again. Anyway.
Can you not hear me?
No, you're fine.
Okay. Yeah, I was going to say Will's son, Jaden Smith, actually does a lot of different shit. He has his music and stuff, and then a clothing line, which I didn't know because I was at Marshall's today. I actually picked up a hoodie of his. He has this clothing line called Raw.
Really?
It's fucking, yeah, let's see it's the hoodie. Cool, what's man.
It
look like?
Go get it. I had to get my mask. Get the hoodie.
Hang on. No, you're not going to be able to see it through the...
Put it on.
I'm going to just show you a picture.
R-A-W?
R-A-W, yeah. This is the hoodie. So the back just says Raw, and then it has this like painting, dude. I thought it was fucking dope. What
the fuck is that?
It looks like a fucking oil painting. And then the front just looks like that.
All right.
I thought it was cool. I was like, dude, how much was that shit? Dude, it was pricey for fucking
that's what I was asking. Jaden Smith, was he asking for things like this?
So the asking so it's going online for like $120 and it's sold out on his website. See, look, like this person's selling it for $400. I don't know if that's really what
Yeah, but anybody can ask whatever, but they're not.
But I got it for available. A fair price. I got it for, you know, I don't like to talk numbers on the air, but.
EDD, baby!
But. Yeah.
Good for you. Where are you going to wear it? When are you going to bust it out? What's the special date?
I don't know. Maybe I'll wear it to Sketched Out.
Oh, snap. It's a good idea, dude.
Yeah.
Maybe I should get something sketched out.
I haven't bought a new shirt or anything in forever. Sketched Out is going to be streamed live from the Comedy Store in Hollywood.
Yeah, we already talked about it.
No matter what. I know. I'm just referring to our new viewers. Our new
it's still the same viewers. One, dude. And I think it's me. I think it's because I have my browser open. We don't have to go over it again. We'll do it at the end of the show. But what else is new?
What else is new with me? I just told you everything.
That's everything? Yo.
You sound like on Joe. She's like, I tell her everything. And she goes, so what else is new? I go, I just told you everything. She goes, yeah, but what else? I'm like, there's nothing else to talk about. I just told you everything.
Dude, when we were driving up to the store the other day.
Oh, she fucking
called. And Joan calls. I was highly entertained. I mean, I love Aunt Joan. We love Aunt Joan. But I feel bad for some of these places. Like that sub place.
Shout out to Newington Pizza.
Newington Pizza. Thank you, Newington. Thank you. Big fat tip coming for
Newington,
you one day.
Actually, we got to give them a legit shout out because Newington Pizza is fucking amazing.
Yeah,
actually.
Shout out Newington.
Thanks
for taking care of Aunt Joan.
Yeah, this is them right here. So currently they're doing all order online, okay? No pickup minimum, but they do have a minimum of $15 for delivery, which isn't bad. And they deliver it to you personally. Apparently Aunt Joan has an issue with Uber Eats. What are the other ones? Fucking... DoorDash and all that shit. Every time there's a driver that comes, she can tell that they opened up the bag, they opened up the box, they look through the food, and then they COVID. Put it back. They put it back, and then they delivered it to her house, which it's this statistically, that's very rare to ever happen, but apparently every time she gets it delivered, that happens. So we ordered from Newington Pizza.
Did you order from Newington Pizza for her?
Yeah, I have to do it online.
You should say, please staple the bag shut with multiple staples. My aunt is Aunt Joan. And then they'll be like, shit.
I think after this last call, they fucking figured that shit out. Because what Sean was saying is she called me pissed off because she knew that the food had been tampered with. The bag had been open, which, no, but... She called them back and the girl was so apologetic, which, you know, goddamn well, that means that driver got in trouble. You know, they were like, yo, why are you fucking with people's food? And he's like, what are you talking about? And he's like, yeah, this bitch said you fucked with her food.
Yeah. All because the person who put the sandwich in the bag turned it a little bit to where it wasn't even. So
can't do that.
He's like, what the fuck is this? Someone's messing with my shit. This is they're gonna have to make me a new one. They got to make me a new one. I don't know.
I'd be so pissed off. Same with the fucking Caitlin from whatever company that was helping her through rehab. She gave her a 1-star review.
You were telling me that one.
After all of her help and everything.
But the thing is, like, old people, bro, sometimes this is the thing. If you're supposed to give a review 1 to 10, and then you see that old person just gave either a 1 or a 10 and then didn't write shit, that old person is either thinking that that 1 is the best and they just left the, like, oh, they're great, I love her, 1 star, because they're just old and they're thinking 1 is great.
Yeah.
Or they're thinking that bitch was I hate her, fuck that lady. And then just giving her a 1. But you know what I mean? It's either 1 or the other. But regardless, yeah, that girl just got 1 star and she's getting in trouble.
Yeah.
It's tough dealing with old people.
My dad had to call and explain that Aunt Jones just fucked up in the head.
There's a lot of people.
Aunt Joan is asking about Sketched Out. She's like, where can I see your stuff? I'm not fucking... First of all, ladies and gentlemen, it's mind-blowing that she hasn't found the videos of herself online, because on the website, there's a tab that is literally dedicated to her. It's called Family Fun. It's shortened with Fam Fun. And when you click it, it has a little dancing hot dog, worry, fear, anxiety, OCD, panic. all of Anchong's qualities, and then the whole section is here. Oh, what the fuck happened here? We got to fix that. Oop. Yeah, everything's on there. And except for that, I don't know what video that is, but it's amazing that she hasn't found it.
Oh, you know, you ever watch Pauly Shore's Random Rants? Do you ever listen to
yeah. that podcast? Yeah, yeah.
Dude,
is his podcast part of that, or is that something different? I've seen his podcast now.
He does a lot of shit, actually. I love Pauly Shore, man. Again, I grew up with Pauly Shore. So I like watching his, like, on Mondays, he posts those, like, workout videos that he does with that girl. I can't remember her name right now.
Yeah, dude, he's posting so much content.
So much. He's does random rants. I remember when he was just walking around doing his random rants to random people in Hawaii. But just recently, I think...
Anita goes, I'm the one viewer.
Shout out to Anita. What's up, Anita? Thanks for watching. he just, you know, all things funny? Or
yeah, ATC. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yep. ATF. What the fuck am I talking about?
Pauly Shore just did a podcast, his Random Rants podcast, but it was totally different. Instead, he sat down with Mike Binder, the producer cool. and director of the Showtime podcast.
Yeah, I didn't Showtime see the podcast, but I saw that.
It was cool, man. It was an hour long, and you know, it was really interesting to listen to, because you know, Mike was a comic there. You know, back in the day, and he kind of tells a story of how he drove out there with a friend, went to the store, saw it was closed. Then he went to like the Westwood location, met Mitzi on like a Monday. By Wednesday, he was like in with her. Like everything was like cool. He was like a paid regular. Shit just happened real quick for him. He just got so like, he just felt like so like fortunate, lucky. He actually went into like parts where he'd like, you know, talked a little bit more about his relationship with her, and it was really interesting listening to this, because later on he kind of went back into how he fell back in love with Mitzi when he was doing this documentary. So I guess they were like real close. He said they were real close at a certain point, and the kind of things kind of drifted a little bit. He tells a story, so it's really interesting. You guys should check it out. As you could just find that on YouTube, on Pauly Shore's YouTube channel. Yeah, really, really good. Just talks about how we shot the documentary and why. And then it's very funny because then, like, you know what? Like, it's always, look, it's tough. It's tough when you're somebody like Joe Rogan, right? Where you're going to have guests on your podcast all the time. Sometimes someone is authors, people who like movie makers, people from anywhere, right? So you can't expect... If he's going to have three authors on, he can't read three books in fucking 2 days, you know, 4 days, whatever. You know what I mean? He can't like be up to date, but it's always good to like have a good idea of what the fuck you're talking about. Sometimes you watch interviews with people and they have no idea what they're, and they're just trying to bullshit their way through it.
That's me.
You know what it was? Joe Rogan did it. I think his worst interview ever was when he had Tom DeLonge on the last time. Dude. And he was basically making fun of him with the whole UFO shit. He didn't really know anything about any of this shit. Tom DeLonge kept saying, dude, did you read the book? Did you read it? Like, come on, did you read it? Like,
but in Joe's but in Joe's defense, some of the shit did sound pretty out there. And Tom DeLonge just kept saying, well, I can't go into that. But this. And then he's like, well, what do you mean you can't go into that?
I know.
You keep saying this stuff, but you can't go into it.
It's hard to like, you know, because if you can't say what your sources are, you feel like you can just say anything, and like that's not really fair to just be able to say anything without being able to back it up, or you know, like, or so I get where Joe Rogan's coming from, and I get that he can't read and watch everything. There was a point where And I'm not saying that Pauly Shore is guilty of this at all, but it was a funny point to me. I thought it was pretty funny where Pauly Shore is like, yeah, well, like, you know, he was asking him about the documentary and like, And he's like, and then you come in with like the animation and stuff like that. And then Mike was like, what? He's like, yeah, you know, like the animations and stuff, like the illustrations. And he's like, there's no animations. And he's like, no, there's no illustrations. And then he's like, no, like, he's like, are you thinking of like something? Are you thinking of something else? And he's like, I don't know. Let's move on. And then, like, it's like so funny. It's so fucking hilarious to me. I'm just laughing so hard. but it was really good. Check that out too. That was funny. It was good to watch. It was just interesting. Both guys, really cool guys.
I can't imagine, dude, having to you know, like, interview someone and then research their shit and then talk to them about it and then know that I'm gonna be doing that same shit 2 days later. So my mind would be all over the fucking place. So to sit here and like remotely have a connecting conversation in the time that you know you're gonna have to do it again. I mean, I'm sure you get used to it. I don't know. I'd be like, yeah, you know.
What, like doing an interview? Interview? But that's why it's so great when Pauly Shore gives the interview, because, you know, Pauly is Mitzi's son, and he's known Mike since he was 7.
Yeah, it's crazy.
And
he was saying, like, a lot of comics, they're like, I don't want to say raised him, but they, you know, like, they were around, like, bringing.
He, at one point in the interview, like, he was saying, Mike said that, you know, he's like, I've been clean for 30 something years, and I owe a lot of that to your mother. And, you know, that's true. She helped a lot of people, like, try to kick drugs and alcohol. She gave people places to stay when they were homeless. She let them, and I guess he was one of the guys that she helped kick, and he's been sober for 30 something years now.
Wow.
And then he's like, Pauly was like, I didn't know that you did drugs. You never did drugs, you know, in front of me. You never high in front of me. He's like, what are you talking about? He's like, I was always high. I always did drugs right in front of you. But he was like 7. It's like, you don't know what that shit is when you're 7. But like, yeah, you know, Pauly grew up at the club. You know, he grew up around this. Mike was a comic at the club. So, you know, it was cool watching Pauly, you know, give him, you know, ask the questions, because it's like such a level of respect there, and it's part of the family, you know what I mean? So it's not just like it was directed by someone else that it didn't have a connection with the store. It was special, right? Because he's connected to the store, you know what I mean? I think this was his first documentary that he's ever done. He's done other movies before. Mike,
yeah, and, no, I did. I literally think it was so well done, and very just informative and interesting, and at the end of the episode it kept you wanting more for the next one, which is great.
Real good.
So if you guys haven't seen it, check it out. Showtime. You can I think you can also do a 1 week pass on there.
You can. Isn't it like just fucking insane, like what we're doing here? Like look how crazy this has become. If you want to watch Pauly Shore's Random Rants, really awesome. It's highly recommended. Go check it out on YouTube. If you want to go watch this, go check it out on Showtime. If you want to go check this out, HBO Max. It's like, it's, you know, it's just everything is all over the place. It would be really nice to just have one place. I know the Apple TV service is supposed to kind of like you log in like one place to all your accounts. If you have Hulu, if you have Amazon Prime, and you just search through the Apple app, and it just brings you to your content no matter which one of your streaming services.
Yeah, but the thing is we're slowly going back to basically what cable was. We're slowly just going to go back to everything packaged together, and it's $200 a fucking month. And you're like, yeah, I'll pay that. Fine. I need all this.
Because the next thing you know, you're like, I got HBO Max. I got Showtime now. I've got Amazon. I've got Hulu. Yeah, I've got YouTube TV. Dude, and then you're paying $130
what you were paying before. That's why they're doing it, though. They're literally doing it to do that again.
Need any of that shit. You can always create an email and get that for 7 days, ladies and gentlemen. 14 days sometimes. You never know.
Or 30 days sometimes.
Yeah.
And then you can let the 30 days roll over to 31, and you mistake it for the wrong day on your calendar, and you contact the service and you say that your son stole your credit card and incorrectly, without permission, used it, and you want your money back.
I want my $5 back for that OnlyFans. He stole the credit card again.
Those fucking tits.
Yeah, those tits aren't worth it.
Tits are garbage tits.
Yeah, I'm going to have a talk with him and show him. Tits. I'm going to have to sit down with my son and show him what real nice tits are.
Absolute trash tits. Well, ladies and gentlemen, speaking of trash tits, we do iPhone a little 12. Segment on here.
My iPhone 12 mini just got ordered, just got placed. I guess it's shipping now.
Oh, wow.
Finally.
And when are you getting it?
I don't know, maybe tomorrow.
Nice. Really? You want to...
Bro, just real quick.
Yeah.
I've been talking to all these assholes over at T-Mobile. I know that we've talked about it on the other episodes. So I don't want to get into it again. But I've been getting the Philippines call center over there. And they don't know what the fuck's going on. They really don't have a clue. It's very difficult. He actually said, he told me that he's going to comp me half the price of the new iPhone that I just ordered. So
wait, is this the guy in the Philippines or is this the guy in the United States?
This is the supervisor. I was talking to this. I was speaking to the supervisor in the Philippines. He's like, I'm going to call you back in an hour. That was like a week ago. I never heard from the guy again. The next day I spoke to someone else, also got redirected to a woman in the Philippines. She told me that there's not much she could do because she's still waiting for the supervisor. I'm like, yeah, that supervisor was supposed to call me back yesterday. He told me in an hour. She's like, I just messaged him. He'll definitely call you back today, I promise. I'm like, you can't promise. He never called back. Never heard back from this guy. Anyway, on a Monday, I called. I waited 30 minutes only instead of the 2 hours like usual. And I got this guy from America. He's in Oregon. He's working from home, but... He heard me. He couldn't believe it. Instantly gave me a $25 credit in my account. Couldn't believe the shit was going on. Saw the notes at the compensation. Escalated it to his manager. Said, let me figure out. I need 4 days on this. I'll call you back on Friday. Friday before noon. I was like, yeah, but that's what everybody says. That's what everybody fucking says. I'll call you in an hour. You'll have your phone on this day. You're going to get it comped. You guys just fucking say nothing. You just guys say whatever you want. It's crazy. He's like, yo, but I put my manager on this. And the difference here is in the United States, I could lose my job if I don't call you back. I'm definitely going to call you back. I'm like, all right. That motherfucker never called me back, bro. And the problem is that was on a Friday. So all Friday goes by. He doesn't call me back. If you call on a Saturday or Sunday, guess where your call's going?
Philippines, baby.
Fucking Philippines. So now since he didn't call on Friday, I can't call until tomorrow. But I'm, as much as I want the phone, I want it half off. You know what I'm saying? And I'm still going to fucking fight for that shit because that's what the asshole told me. But it hurts my argument if it's already on the way. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So if I don't have it, I can be like, you motherfuckers, I was supposed to have it by now. But now they could be like, it's on its way. And I could be like, yeah, but still, you said you were going to call me. You know what I mean? It's just like, it just changes the argument a little bit. So first thing tomorrow morning, I got to get on the phone and fight for this shit.
Ah, Jesus. Well, you know what you got to do right now? You got to take all that anger and frustration and put it on someone on Chat Roulette.
I think you're right, bro. Are you saying you want me to go first?
I do.
All right, then. You load it up.
And if you need conversation topics, feel free to use my poem.
I'm going to pass the poem. I think that's more authentic to you. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, right? You spit it out with such passion. Sound like I'm reading it. And they're like, what the fuck does this guy say? They don't want anything to do with me.
That's true.
All right, I'm just like passing all my goals with when you set your goals real low, like you're just sitting on the couch watching TV and it's just congratulations, you just fucking completed your exercise goal for the day. I'm like, yes.
I should get one of those. I can only imagine what the fucking thing it would say. It would explode.
Set it real. I know. Oh man. All right, let me share this bitch. Get on this Chat Roulette. Advanced portion. Boom. Okie dokes. Let me expand this. You know what I think I might need? All right. Sorry, I didn't know that I was going to be going first, but you're right. I'm pissed off at these assholes over at T-Mobile, and I got to let somebody know about it.
Yeah, you got to let them know. You really got to let them know.
Ugh. What is this shit? Okay, bam. I got to pick the worst show ever. All right. Random chat. Nudity ban. That's what we want here.
Yeah, that has as much legitimacy as the people getting fired in the Philippines.
I know. Idiots. I'm trying to make myself look a little decent there. All right. Let's get.
Yeah.
Yo.
Look at that circle.
Whoa. I know that's new. Whoa, what's up, you piece of shit? Whoa.
Remy.
Whoa.
Ratatouille.
What are you doing?
All my dreams.
That's weird. What is that?
Huh?
What the fuck? What the hell's going on?
How are you calling me right now?
On the phone. Answer. How? Are you going to answer the phone or what?
How are you calling me?
What's up, bro? What are you doing? I just asked you a question, bro. What are you doing?
This headphone doesn't work.
Yo, your fucking headphones don't work. Idiot. Remember when people used to do that? With Napoleon Dynamite?
Yeah. And Borat.
Oh, yeah.
Copy everything with Borat.
Is this the same fucking guy, but a different angle?
Are you a streamer? A streamer?
I'm a streamer, baby. Yes.
Look at those teeth.
Stop it. Don't make fun of him. You're an asshole. Oh, he can't hear you.
I mean,
everybody else can.
Those teeth were jacked up. He's got to go do something.
Oh, man. What is this? You're
Muy buenas noches. En los próximos 5 o 10 minutos soy tu psicólogo personal. Si tienes alguna duda o pregunta, dímelo. Intentaré resolvértelo.
Get your fucking mouth away from the microphone, asshole. It's too close.
Bro, do you speak Spanish?
You seem to speak English, so what the fuck?
My English is so bad. I'm from Peru. My English is so bad.
I don't speak Spanish, so this is gonna have to do.
Yeah, goodbye, man.
Goodbye. No, let's make it work. Let's make it work, baby. I love you.
I love you, bro.
Okay. Bye, bye.
Bye.
So you got to make it work, you know.
I wonder what he was saying in the beginning.
I don't know.
It sounded good.
What's up, dude? What are you doing? Are you that's a fucking crazy. What the fuck? Fuck you. Get so mad. It's that T-Mobile guy. Thinking about him. Oh, what's going on, girls? Woo, woo.
Oh my god.
You are streaming live on the worst show ever. Holla at your boy. Woo!
Wow.
Gross. That's playing with his. Yeah, what up? What the hell? You are. That guy was in his gaming chair with his Paul Kilmer headset on, just whacking it hardcore. Like the whole chair was shaking and making noises. All right, let's get some fun. Yo, what up, bro? What are you doing? I didn't like that guy anyway. Nice pimples, asshole. Hey, why are we looking at your pimples? Nobody wants to see that. All right. start doing. Thanks. Yo, 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 bro, yo.
Wow. I think I could even do better than that.
Shit. That guy looked like...
It sounded like he had it, and then he like struggled.
Oh, you know, he never had it. What up, bro? Do you have it? Yes or no? Yo, what's up, dude? I'm gonna give somebody the chance.
I'm gonna go fuck themselves.
What's up, bro? I'm gonna give somebody a chance to try to blow off some steam a little bit. You know, just maybe something's bothering them. They want to just talk about, yo, dickhead, sit down. Let's chat. Take a seat, asshole. I want to talk to you.
Maybe for chat roulette, we should pick a more plain background. I feel like it kind of looks insane with the chat roulette or the worst show ever one.
Who cares? You know? No. Yo, what's up? Can I do you have anything that you want to take your aggression out on? Are you pissed off about something? Something that you just want to complain about? Everything's perfect? Yeah, you know what's not perfect? Your microphone. We can't hear you. It's not working. It's just not working.
She was too happy.
What up, bro? Are you taking a shit? That guy looks way too comfortable to be shitting like that. What up, bro? You mad about something? You want to complain?
Tell them why you're mad. Did they ever have that in New York?
What?
On the radio station, Hot 97, tell them why you're mad.
Yo, what up? You speak English? Hey, fuck you, dickhead. Nah.
Your mama. Your mother.
Hey, do you want to complain about something? Is something bothering you?
No entiendo un rábano.
Who's that, your little sister?
Yo no hablo inglés. I not speaking English.
Flip him off.
You speak Spanish?
Como mi mierda.
Ah, bueno, cómasela. Cómasela.
Come mi mierda.
Ah, que yo, la tuya.
I don't know. I'm so glad I'm not in that guy's room, you know?
What the fuck is going on in
there? Unbelievable. Some girl in there just laughing.
That's like a child, dude. It's like a baby.
Bro, what are you doing?
Nothing, bro. And you?
Yo, let me ask you something. You want to complain about something? You pissed off? I'll listen. Just now's your chance. What's bothering you, bro? Anything. Oh, he's gonna tell me something.
The panic that set in on that guy.
It's like, holy shit. Yo, what up, bro? Why are you so mad, man? You look pissed.
What?
Why are you so mad, bro? You look so mad.
Are you mad? Fine.
Okay.
No.
Okay. You're happy now? Oh, this is not gonna be good. Fucking goddamn it.
His connection, dude.
There's like a 3-second delay. What up, bro?
Dude, that's a painting Pam and Jim had on their
wall. What's up, bro?
What's happening, man?
Yo, is that the painting that Pam and Jim had on the wall?
What?
That painting that behind you, is that the same one that Pam and Jim had on the wall from the office?
No, this is my room, man.
Bro, your shit is dope. Look at that shit. I like the bricks. Huh?
Thank you. I'm from Serbia. Where are you from?
I'm from California, United States of America.
California. Yep. The independent states between all.
Hey, man.
I learned your culture, you know.
Let's hear it. What do you learn? Tell me about our culture.
Liberals, you know, you know what I'm talking about. I don't want to use that topic. I know that Trump needed to win, but Joe Biden won. So what the fuck, you know? Really, Trump created jobs. Really, really created.
Dude, where do you live again? Serbia?
In Belgrade, capital city, Belgrade.
Okay, what were you going to say? He created jobs because what?
He increased his job influence, you know, more jobs because of tax cuts.
You don't know anything about Donald Trump, bro.
No. Donald Trump is reality mascot, you know, and everything.
You look like a mascot with that hat.
Because I am ultra. You know what is ultra soccer fan?
No, what is that?
Ultra way of life, you know.
Ultra just way of life?
Do you wanna see?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Wait a second. Okay. I just bought a new keyboard.
Yeah, that shit is fire, son.
It's like a GX Scorpion, you know?
Damn.
Look at that shit. And look at this. This is normal.
Wow.
Like gaming stuff, you know?
It is. Again. How much is that shit?
because I pay from the PayPal money, you can't have it in your hand. You must use it online, you know?
Uh-huh.
And you have a lot of things. You have a Scorpion K10. You have a Scorpion. This is K220.
Okay, cool. What were you going to tell me about the hat? Show me what you're going to show me.
This hat, this is like Taurunum, Taurus. You know what is Taurus?
No. Like a Ford Taurus?
Listen,
a Taurus, a bull.
No. Old name for the Belgrade is Singidunum. It's a Viking capital.
Okay, but what were you saying? I'm losing interest really quick here. What were you going to show me? Bro, are you high? All of it. Remember you were going to show me something and then you saw your, and then you showed me your keyboard, and then now all of a sudden, I don't know where we're going, but...
I go on three different places.
Yeah, let's get back on.
All right.
I'm so hyped, man. Look at this, and I want to see your reaction. You know.
Okay.
I want to see your reaction.
All right.
Look at this. Did you see it?
What the hell was that?
Just texted ultra or way of life.
No, it's okay. Gotta go. Bye. I feel like he's gonna show me something that's gonna ruin my life. What's up? Are we sleeping? What kind of fucking position is this? What are you doing? Wake up, idiot. All right, Colton, you want to get on this thing?
Yeah, you were getting into some weird political bullshit.
No, I wasn't. He was. I love when they start talking about it, and they're like, I don't want to bring it up. What's up, dickhead?
Yeah, yeah. What are you doing? Do you speak Spanish?
Do you speak English?
So menos.
Yeah, it looks like we have a bit of a problem then. Go. Tell your dog to shut the fuck up.
Yes, I have three dogs.
Pero.
Perros, dogs.
Sí.
Three dogs.
Okay, bye-bye. All right, you ready?
I'm trying to get it going. Jesus Christ.
Hurry up, bro. I don't want to be on here anymore. What's up? How you doing, sweetie? What are you Googling?
I'm trying to get the background going.
What are you doing?
It's showing. Okay.
Do you think people want to watch you Google stuff and wipe your face over and over again?
Right.
She thought she was adorable. Hey, what's up? Are you adorable?
All right, I'm gonna take over from here.
All righty.
And hey, what's up, dude?
I had that guy, remember?
I remember. I don't think people like the background. Hey, you like my background?
Yes, I like it.
Whoa. You like my background? You should just have a fucking orgasm.
I know.
Hey.
Now what the fuck?
Whoa, what's with all the cursing?
She wasn't happy with what she saw, bro.
I look like a robot, that's why. I look like fake.
That way? You think you look like a robot?
Yeah. Hey, I wrote a poem, you wanna hear it? It's me, but I'm different. I'm from the Matrix, dude. Remember, we had a talk?
Yeah.
While you're here, let me sell you on something. I'm selling macaroni for half off.
One moment.
Okay.
What's your favorite song?
You know?
What is your favorite song?
Oh, my favorite song. It is 50 Cent in the Club.
Sing, please.
You can find me in the club. Bottle full of bum, my mind got what you need if you're in the getting rub. I'm into having sex, I ain't into making love, so come give me a hug if you're in the getting rub.
You can find me in the like it.
Dude, that's good, man.
That's nice, really
good.
Bro.
Yeah, that's really good.
Your voice is amazing.
Thanks. You should see my privates.
Where are you from, bro?
I'm from the Ukraine. Where are you from?
Ukraine?
Yeah.
I'm from Peru.
I'm just kidding, dude. I'm from Peru, too. I think I saw you on the subway the other day. We were talking about Dunkin' Donuts. You hit that softball at the company picnic?
Picnic.
Are you Richard?
Richard? Or what? I don't speak English. Excuse me.
Oh, that's okay. I love you.
I love you, bro. Nice dick, bro. You're dick.
What's up, dude?
What's up, man?
I wrote a poem.
I'm from Morocco.
Macaroni and butt crack, purple nurple, fat nuggets, buttocks, sex cramp. Please listen carefully as our menu options have changed. Mucous membrane, kingdom come in your asshole, ass turd, buttocks, sex. Bewildering butt crack frolic you see. Look at the size of her bazongas.
I'm not very good in English to understand what's
that's okay.
Behind
what you
say. I felt is there is something behind what you say.
Yeah.
Can't get it. Can't
that's
get
right.
it.
I appreciate Sorry. It. Thank you.
Is it?
See, I'm changing lives. I'm changing lives over here.
What? How?
Well, I wrote a poem. Do you want to hear it?
At some point. Sure. You want to share it with me, yeah.
Well, I'm going into a poetry slam, so that's why I have this like background. It's for Zoom, so I'm doing a poetry slam.
Cool.
Macaroni sure. and butt crack, fat nuggets, buttocks, sex crap. Please listen carefully as our menu options have changed. Mucous membrane, kingdom come in your asshole. Bewildering butt crack, frolic you see. Look at the size of her bazongas. Wash the ass cheeks thoroughly. Why are you laughing?
Because bazongas, I've never heard that word
before. Oh, yeah. I think it means breasts. Huh. ass, maggot, shit, baby burp, teeny bop, mustard, baby shit, mango, tit, shit, piss, asshole, buttocks, dick, bomb, jerk, fuck, son of a fuck, peppermint, dog, shit, baby burp.
End it.
So what do you think?
That's great.
You're getting a call. That better be about my poetry.
Yeah, it's a good call. So much should
happen. Make it to Hollywood? Is that Justin Timberlake? Don't next me.
I mean, I thought,
what's
like...
up, bro? What's up, bro?
I think I heard...
what I want to say is not appropriate for on air.
Yeah. Wow. I heard baby burp twice, a couple of repeats in there, bro.
Well, I'm starting from the top. I mean,
you can't say baby burp twice.
Why not, though?
Because it's special, bro. It needs to be said once. You know what my new favorite part is? The part you say about, like, please stand by for the whatever. Hey.
Oh, wow. That's the guy that was jacking her.
That was the guy, dude. Yeah, his whole chair was making noises. He was going hard.
Hey, you.
Was it please listen closely for the item menus have changed? That's my new favorite part, bro. That shit is good. That's an attention grabber. All of a sudden, you're back in it, you know? It's almost like, please stand clear of the closing doors, please. Stand clear of the closing doors, please. You know, that's New York City subway trains, man. That's all. Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Yeah, I'm really coming into my craft here with the poem.
Throw stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Into Whoa, look at that art.
That's Aunt Joan.
That was Aunt Joan. You have Corona? All right, I'm gonna do a couple more.
Nothing.
I know. I'm adding some more swears in.
Are you still writing your poetry?
I'm always writing this thing.
I can tell it's getting really long. Poem. It's getting lengthy.
Hey, I wrote a poem. See, that's someone that shoots up a high school. That's somebody who's planning to shoot up a high school.
Yeah, they don't care about your poem. 100% they don't care about your poem.
What's up, dude? I don't speak English. See if it works.
You can see that they're trying to line the mouse up on the next button as they're saying what's up. They're like, hey, how can I get rid of this dickhead?
We can do that one.
All right.
Yeah.
Can I rap?
The screaming shower. The words echo off the canyons.
Keep him. Keep him. I want to see that.
I wanted a fucking rap, not him.
He would have seen as good, bro. We got to keep that shit.
Fuck him. My poem is more important.
Yeah. You need a beat. Maybe your poem will come to life with a beat behind it.
Yeah, maybe.
You got that on hand? Can you drop a beat?
They wouldn't hear it, though.
You have like a Wolverine tattoo on his chest? What was that?
The concentration in the eyes.
I know.
Tits!
All right.
All right. One more, boys and girls.
One more. Let's see who it is. No, he doesn't count.
I like that moving circle.
It's interesting. It's keeping my attention.
I wrote a poem. Do you want to hear it?
Be careful with this one. Anything could happen.
For a second, I thought it was that guy that beats the shit out of his own walls.
Oh, man. No, that guy still had way too many walls up.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, you made it to the end. I'm going to keep working on this poem. I think the purple nurple fat chicken nugget buttock sex cramp is a nice tongue twister that gets people's minds going. And then you like the please listen carefully as our menu options have changed. Yeah. Dude, I swear to God, I need to start pulling my car over because I have ideas come to me for it and then I lose them. And then I'm at the grocery store.
Is that your reminder for something?
Yeah, it was my reminder for our promo. I gotta add something in. And what's the promo for?
Sketched out, baby. Oh, did I ruin that for you?
No. I'm setting you up.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Remember, Sketched Out taking place December 10th. Get your submissions in by December 3rd. JPDentertainment.com. Click the Sketched Out tab. Get your fucking submissions in. Done, did them. Make sure they're 3 to 5 minutes in length. And you can submit more than one. But maybe okay. we should limit it pretty soon. Because.
So we're streaming live on Twitch. And it's at Comedy Store, okay? Right. So you either download the Twitch app or you go to twitch.tv, okay? And when you go there, you download, or you don't download anything. You go to...
Let's go to at Comedy Store. Bam. There's the account. Yeah. Set notifications to on.
Not the Comedy Store. That's Comedy Store.
Yeah, it's not that UK. It's not the UK shit. It's not that UK.
Yeah, they
shit.
Have one follower, so they're not doing too well. But
it's the owner.
We can't hate because we have one account. Viewer. We have one viewer. So
anyway, Comedy Store, set the notifications to on, and you'll be notified December 10th.
Bam.
Get your submissions in jpdentertainment.com. It's good times. We're looking forward to it.
I might even do my poem on air there. The management would love that. But we'll probably do it. We'll probably end up doing it.
No, I don't think so. We're not going to do that.
But like we said, guys, the rules are shifting and changing each day. So it might, who knows? By the 10th, it might be back and we could go on the patio. Right now, we're not sure what the case is. So either way, it's going to be streamed live on Twitch. Make sure you go and download the app. Make sure if you can't download the app, you go online to twitch.tv at Comedy Store and just show your tits. Bring your tits.
All right. With that being said, thank you very much for joining us. It's been episode 64 of The Worst Show Ever. We will see you guys next week, whenever the fuck we feel like doing it. Maybe next Sunday, maybe before that. But whatever. See you then. Thanks, guys.
Yep.
Unbelievable. Every time.
Hey, with that,
you gotta do that anyway. I don't know why you keep doing that. Every goddamn all week.
Right.
All right, we'll see you next time.